Emmanuel, Son of God, appear. Heaven and earth rejoice, salvation is drawing near. Salvation is drawing near. O come, Emmanuel. And ransom captive Israel that mourns in lonely exile here until the Son of God appears. Come, come, Emmanuel, Son. Salvation is drawing near. Salvation is drawing near. Rejoice, Emmanuel. Shall come to thee, O Israel. Rejoice, Emmanuel, shall come to thee, O Israel.
Good morning. We welcome all of you to our chapel here at St. Paul Monastery and those also joining us over our ecumenical channel here in Northeast Ohio. As we come together today, we come together on this second Sunday of Advent. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, but may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her service is at an end. Her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hand of the Lord double for all her sins. A voice cries out in the desert, prepare the way for the Lord. Make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill shall be made low. The rugged land shall be made a plain, the rough country, a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of glad tidings. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Fear not to cry out and say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord our God, who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense before him. Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. In his arms he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom and leading the ewes with care. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Proclaims the Lord who speaks of peace. Near to us now God's saving love for those who believe. Come, O Lord, and say, meet in justice and peace, embrace. Truth shall blossom from the earth as the heavens rejoice. Come, O Lord, and say, God shall grant abundant gifts, the earth shall yield its fruit. Justice shall march before our God and guide us to peace. Come, O Lord, and say,
a reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord, one day is like a thousand years, and a thousand years like one day. The Lord does not delay his promise, as some regard delay, but he is patient with you, not wishing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a mighty roar, and the elements will be dissolved by fire. And the earth and everything done on it will be found out. Since everything is to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you to be? Conducting yourselves in holiness and devotion, waiting for and hastening the coming of the glory of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved by flames and the elements melted by fire. But according to his promise, we await new heavens and a new earth in righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you await these things, be eager to be found without spot or blemish before him at peace. The Lord, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Strengthened, that with confidence you can meet the Son of Man. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in Isaiah the prophet, "Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way." A voice of one crying out in the desert, "Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths." John the Baptist appeared in the desert, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. People of the whole Judean countryside and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem were going out to him and were being baptized by him in the Jordan River as they acknowledged their sins. John was clothed in camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist. He fed on locusts and wild honey. And this is what he proclaimed: "One mightier than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop and loosen the thongs of his sandals. I have baptized you with water. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
First of all, in the back of the chapel, you will find a little Advent bulletin that has our Christmas schedule for this year, so you might want to pick one up so you'll know what our Mass times and schedules will be here at St. Paul Monastery. It's the same one we've had for the last 4 or 5 years, but it's basically on Christmas and New Year's, we have a Mass at 7 and 10. The only addition is Christmas Eve, we have a Mass at 8 o'clock. We do not have any midnight Mass because none of us stay up that late. On Christmas Eve, nor on New Year's Eve. So it's just 7 and 10 and then 8 o'clock on Christmas, but you can pick up a schedule for that. Also, just a reminder that today is Father Jim Korda's birthday, so keep him in your thoughts and prayers and pray for him. I also like to mention to you something that came to me this week from the Ohio Right to Life, which I'd like to bring to your attention. This was dated Thursday, December 3rd. It said, "Today, Senate Bill 27, the Unborn Child Dignity Act, passed out of the Ohio House by a vote of 60 to 35. This legislation will ensure the dignity of the unborn through proper burial. State Senate Bill 27 requires the Ohio Department of Health to establish rules for the proper and humane burial or cremation of children who lost their lives to an abortion procedure. Up until now, they could just throw the body into a trash. And so this says, now requires that either the mother could say, I want it cremated, or I would like to have it buried. And if she doesn't want to make the decision, then the provider has to make the decision one way or the other. And it passed, of course, 60 to 35. My question is, why did 35 people vote against it? And I won't tell you which party voted against it, but you can probably guess on that. Last week we began first Sunday of Advent saying let's don't rush Christmas too much, let's celebrate the season of Advent, and so we begin to prepare. So this week we get to reflect upon how do we prepare ourselves. Now for some of us to begin the preparation, we might decide to send Christmas cards. So it might be a scene of the nativity, or maybe there's some wise men coming, or maybe it's angels, or maybe it's just a nice winter scene. Maybe it's some poinsettias or some other flowery item on there that we will send out to people to begin the process of wishing them a very Merry Christmas. Or perhaps we are beginning to set up our nativity scene. Now, we'll set ours up in a little bit so we can hide the band on Sunday. So we put it up here. And so we'll have our angel and we'll have the Holy Family. Now, some of us may have a little more elaborate where we will have some animals. We will have the shepherds. We will have the wise men. I remember, and our guys from New York remind us, years ago, we just have a nativity in New York in front of our altar, and the brother who set it up decided that the wise men weren't there at the beginning, so they started the wise men like over by the podium, and then the wise men each Sunday would work their way across, and then on Epiphany would show up at the nativity, so you'd have to do that. But sometimes when you go driving around, you'll find that Santa Claus shows up at the nativity scene, or maybe some other inflatable animals will show up one way or the other. Or I saw one last year, I haven't seen it this year, that the nativity were three dinosaurs out on the front lawn, you know, mom and dad and the baby, they had red hats and everything. So there might be some variety of things on our nativity scenes. Or we start singing Christmas carols, or we start singing songs, which reminds me of a comic strip I saw several years ago where it says, oh, great, we're starting to sing Christmas, or for us during Advent, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. He said, I love that song, except I know in about 4 weeks I'm going to get tired of that song, because we keep singing it all the time. So these are the things that we're preparing. Now, all these things, the Christmas carols, the Christmas cards, the nativity scene, we're missing one character that the church brings into our lives during the season of Advent, and that's John the Baptist. Now, you're going to tell me, well, John the Baptist wasn't there for the nativity. Well, of course he wasn't there, technically. I mean, he was in the world, but he wasn't right there. But the church puts him on the second Sunday of Advent every year, because he is the one that's calling people to repentance, call people to change their lives, call people to return back to the Lord. And that's why we are preparing ourselves, turning back to the Lord. He quotes Isaiah, our first reading today. Isaiah is giving the people a sense of hope. We're bringing you out of captivity. We're bringing you out of being in exile, and we're going to bring you back home. And the Lord's going to be there with you on the long journey. You're going to go through hills. You're going to go through plains. You're going to go through deserts. There are going to be potholes. There's going to be crooked ways, and we're going to make everything easy for you to return back to the Lord. And that's what the Lord is preparing for us. What are the potholes we need to fill in? What are the ways we need to make straight? What are the mountains we need to lower as we come back to the Lord? So some ways that we can prepare, first of all, it is a season of repentance. And oftentimes churches have offered penance services during the Advent season. I don't know if churches are doing that these days or not. If it is, it's going to be very limited. But even if we don't get to confession during this time, we can still confess to the Lord. We can still admit that we have sinned, admit that we've lost our way, admit at times we said, Lord, we don't need you in our lives, and ask him to welcome us back back, ask him to forgive. And so there's the opportunity during this season to return back to the Lord in that way. It's also an opportunity to deepen our spirituality. I mentioned beginning reading the Gospel of Luke starting on the 1st of December, and there's only 24 chapters. So if you read a chapter a day, it'll bring you up to Christmas Eve, and then you would have read the entire life of Jesus Christ. If you read today in this chapter 6, there's lots of healings, there's lots of cures, there's lots of reflections in the beginning of the Sermon on the Plain, as it's called in the Gospel of Luke. And so there's much to reflect upon, and that may be a way of preparing. Or you can find the Magnificat, you can find the Give Us This Day, you can find the Word Among Us, or any other booklet that may give a daily reflection so that you can reflect upon what each day calls us to do. Or maybe you come to Mass a little bit more than just Sundays so that we can enter the where the presence of the Lord is calling us. Or maybe there's a program on the internet that we want to reflect upon, and something in Scripture or the Bible that enables us to deepen our Lord. So we deepen our experience of the Lord into our life. Then it's an opportunity also to reach out to others. Maybe this is a time to reflect upon how we are meeting with family and friends. A number of us were planning on going home this Christmas, but because of the pandemic, we're all going to stay here. So I think this is maybe the first time that our entire community will be together at Christmas. So we'll create a whole new family, but then we will be meeting with our families by Zoom or Skype or FaceTime or whatever other way that we can connect. So maybe you're doing that because your families can't come together. But maybe we can be that neighbor and friend that reaches out and helps. Maybe bring the body of Christ to them, get a pix, find a special way to bring the body of Christ back to your family or friends. Or maybe there's an opportunity to go visit with them, even though it might be social distancing. Maybe we offer to pick up some food for persons, or help them to take their packages to the post office, or maybe help them to order online if they are not familiar with how to use those functions, and able to assist with them. And I think also more importantly is to be with people who for this Christmas are going to be without a loved one who may have died because of the pandemic. And so they're going to be lonely at this time, and they're going to be depressed, and they're going to be in grieving process, that we can journey with them and be with them. And also pray for all those who are encountering COVID in their lives, especially my niece who's just got tested positive last week in Kentucky. And also all those here in our neighborhoods and friends, and also the caregivers for all these people. And pray that the vaccine will come out soon for all of us and work for us. And in this way, we can prepare ourselves openly to welcome the Lord into our life. So this week is an opportunity to reflect, where am I on my preparation that brings me closer to the Lord as I welcome him more and more, getting closer to Christmas in our own lives. Let us stand together now and share our profession of faith. And this morning, let us say the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. As we prepare for the coming of Christ into the world, let us call to mind those areas of our world that need his presence.
For the church, that during this Advent season, God will give us energy to pursue conversion, advocate for justice and peace, and be heralds of God's presence in our midst. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are alone and in isolation, that God will sustain them, help them be aware of the blessings in their lives, and help us to reach out and accompany them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
and for all who are combating the coronavirus, that God will bring them healing to the sick, strengthen those who care for them, and success for those who will soon be vaccinated. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the homebound, that God will protect them, renew their spirits, and restore them to wholeness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for peace throughout the world, that God will turn the hearts of the world leaders from violence toward cooperation, facing the challenges to confront the human race. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And as we pray this Mass, let us remember Norma Osio. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Generous and merciful God, source of all wisdom, guide us on the right path. Listen to the prayers we make to you and grant them in your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Beyond the moon and stars, as deep as night, so great our hunger,
my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings. And since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
In the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, all our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Nicholas, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us turn and offer to each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us be bread blessed by the Lord, broken and shared, life for the world. Let us be wine, love freely poured. Let us be one in the Lord.
Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. We thank all of you for joining us here at our chapel at St. Paul Monastery, and especially those joining us over our ecumenical channel. We thank our musicians, we thank our reader, and remind you to pick up a mass schedule, and the Catholic Exponent is also available for you. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thank you, God.
Prepare in the wilderness a highway for our God. Let mountains and hills be made low. Let the lowlands and valleys be raised. For the Lord reveals his power. The Lord comes as a lamb. The Lord is born as a man.